Good evening, everyone. So what we're going to talk about now is immunodeficiency and allergies. So in the last decades, powerful molecular techniques has accelerated the pace of discovery of several new primary immunodeficiency. Genetic advances has given us the chance to have more precise phenotyping of associated skin, respiratory and digestive symptoms in immunodeficient patients. Thus, several studies has established the relation between subclasses immunoglobulin G deficiency and frequent sinusitis, and the relation between PID and eczema or atopic dermatitis, and the relation between PID and asthma. So our study was a retrospective one that was between 2008 and 2015. So it enrolled 20 patients that has PID plus skin, digestive, respiratory symptoms. So the question was this allergy and how come this allergic manifestation was associated with PID? So the aim of our study was to study the prevalence of this association and the clinical manifestations. So the mean age of our patients were almost 9 years. The first symptoms onset was at 23 months. The diagnosis age was 5 years, and the sex ratio were 1.7. The prevalence of allergies among PID, the first one that we found were asthma. It was almost the half of all the manifestations. Then sinusitis, followed by all the others, such as food allergy, atopic dermatitis, and the association between asthma and atopic dermatitis, sinusitis, eczema, or rhinitis. The PID that was associated the most with allergy was hyper-IgE syndrome, which is more than the half, followed by IgA deficiency and all the others, such as HLA class 2 deficiency, NK deficiency, Netherton syndrome, SCID, and all the others. Our blood analyses showed a mean rate of eosinophilic cells that was to 12,864, and the mean rate of IgE was 15,900. Regarding the IgA deficiency, the mean rate of eosinophilic cells were 320 elements, and the mean rate of IgE was less than 2,000 units per milliliter. The images that we found in the lung CT scan were bronchiectasis, and these images are one of our patients in the units. So there is not enough studies about this subject, but those that are available showed that the mean age of diagnosis, such as in the study of Agha Mohammadi, was 5 years. So this is a late age of diagnosis. So every doctor should ask about the recurrent infections and ask about family history of PID. We will start with PID and cutaneous or digestive symptoms. So back in 1966, the syndrome of hyper-IgE was described as the association between cold abscesses, dermatitis or eczema, and asthma. There are two forms of this syndrome. The first one is autosomic recessive, which is the mutation of the DOC8 gene. And in this form, we see food allergy the most, followed by dermatitis and then asthma. The form that is autosomic dominant, which is a mutation of the gene STAT3, so the food allergy is seen, but not as frequently as in the recessive form. And the form that is associated with mutation of TIC2, the manifestation that we find is the eczema and some predisposition to mycobacteria infection. Finally, there is the phosphoglucomitase 3 deficiency, which is quite recently, and it associated atopic dermatitis, recurrent infections, and asthma. There are also some oesogastric allergy, which associate oesophagitis and eosinophilia, and finally the IPEX syndrome that associate diarrhea, food allergy, atopic dermatitis, and diabetes. Regarding the PID associated to asthma, the form that is autosomic recessive of the syndrome of hyper-IgE, which is the mutation of duckweed, is the most frequently found associated with asthma, followed by the phosphoglucomatase 3, and then the hypogammaglobulinemia, and it can be explained by recurrent infections that maintain inflammation and then maintain the frequent asthma exacerbations. This slide shows that, as we said, the deficiency of duckweed, which is the recessive form of the hyper-IgE syndrome, is the one that is associated the most with allergy and asthma. Regarding the association between the PID and renal sinusitis, we found that 57% of ORL or pulmonary chronic infections are associated with subclasses IgG deficiency. And in the study done by Shapiro that enrolled 67 children, sinusitis resistant to treatment was associated with the syndrome hyper-IgE in 8%, with IgG deficiency in 18%. And it is important to add that the allergic rhinitis and sinusitis are independent common disorder, but studies document the presence of both disorders in the same patient in 25% to 70% of the time. And immunodeficiency seems to play an independent role in resistant and severe sinusitis. Regarding the blood analysis, in the form that is autosomic dominant, the IgE rate is usually above 2,000 units per milliliter. It is the same case in our study, and eosinophilia is important also in 93%. In hypogammaglobulinemia, the eosinophilic cells rate and the IgE rate is not as high as in patients with allergy only. Finally, in the IgA deficiency, there is a normal rate of IgE and eosinophilic cells. The images that we found in the lung CT scan in the association between PID and respiratory symptoms are bronchiectasis, as we find in the patients in almost all our patients having respiratory syndrome. So to conclude, we had some limits in our study, which were the retrospective form of the study and few allergy tests that were not all available. But we have to say that more studies are needed about allergy among immunodeficient patients to make the difference between severe atopic dermatitis and the form of syndrome of hyper-IgE. Thank you.